everyone. This video is mostly about X Factor and Lady Gaga on X Factor. But for those of you who don't watch X Factor and why aren't you, I'm talking about sexy YouTubers and SNL controversy, why I haven't seen New Moon yet, and there's some overtime sexy at the end. Warning, objects at the end of this video may appear sexier than they are. I love that song. And objects in the rearview mirror may appear sexier than they are. Daniel, you should have sang that. I'm a social. Love you, bitch. I whip it out whenever I can. What the fuck? I had to have it. What the fuck? So it was the week before the finals. I guess that makes it the semifinals. So it was the semifinals on X Factor this weekend, and the top four battled for three spots in the finals. Daniel Johnson sang Man in the Mirror. It was Michael Jackson week. He started slow and then started snapping and pointing, and he slapped his belly, and he did his signature toss the microphone. Simon and Cheryl stood up. It was really good. I dug it. Danny and Louie made fun of the polar bear on the screen, distracting from his voice. I didn't even notice it, and trust me, I tend to notice polar bears, so it must not have distracted me from his voice. I just love the element, side note, on this show that the judges are mentors and they fight for their acts. Simon fights for Ollie and Daniel, Cheryl fights for Joe, Danny fights for Stacy, and Louie just fights with polar bears. I love when Daniel tosses his mic. It's like a party trick. Like, everyone knows he can do it and the crowd wants it, so he has to do it. Let's call him Tosser. Tosser's second song was I Have Nothing by Whitney Houston. I love that song. Whenever a girl sings that on American Idol, Simon is like, oh, don't do it. But when a guy does it, it's original and okay. I think it lacked emotion, even when, like, the slow part, don't walk away, the slow part, I didn't feel the desperation enough, because Daniel's like, I'm Daniel, I am nothing without me. Simon says he has not received fair criticism so far, and he deserves a place in the finals. Of course he does. I thought he sounded shaky this weekend. He never really wailed like he did that first week. Remember that first week? Ollie Ollie Oxenfree's first song was Can You Feel It? And he was on a big cake of stairs, and I could feel it in my pants, but vocally I wasn't feeling it. I don't think there's ever been such a fun performance on any of these shows, Britain's Got Talent, America's Got Talent, American Idol. I mean, Jedward, you don't count, but Ollie, he is such a joy to watch. He is so old school. And Danny said he grabbed his package. Maybe that could be your signature move. If Daniel can toss a mic, you can toss your mic. Woo! I didn't see that part. Did anyone catch it? His second song was We Can Work It Out. I love that he moved away from the mic and did some arm and foot dancing. Ollie has the moves. And then he did some extra stanky legs at the end. It was kind of odd because it didn't feel like a dance song, but he turned it into one. Not a great song choice, as the judges said, but as always with Ollie, it was a great performance. Joe sang She's Out of My Life. It was a very quiet, elegant performance. You could really hear the quality of his voice. There was no backing, anything. I just think there was a piano. It was very impressive that it was so stripped down. Cheryl stood up. Simon said he was getting better and better. He is. I'm totally into Joe now. His other song was Open Arms. I loved it. Simon and Cheryl stood this time. Louis said it could be a number one song. Simon said no one's ever heard of that song. I've heard of that song. Have you heard of that song? I love that song. Stacey Solomon's first song was The Way You Make Me Feel. She sauntered around in a sassy hat. And what do we know about girls who wear sassy hats? What did I say in the last video? Big brain, bad roots. I knew Simon wasn't gonna like it, and there was Danny, like a stage mother, cheering from her seat. Simon said it was fine, but not her. Agreed. Her second number was Somewhere from West Side Story. I liked parts of it. Part of it were a little uncomfortable. She seemed like all over the place vocally. The big notes were good, like somehow, someday, and then Danny was in her chair and started to sing, and she cracked somewhere. Danny totally made her crack. You notice that? The moment Danny stood up, she cracked, and then she chewed out her mouth and stuck out her tongue and made a face. The diva from Dogga Bomb! It gave Cheryl goosebumps. And like Danny reminded us, keep this in mind about Stacy. She has no performing experience, so she has done so well. Someone wrote on my Facebook, Stacy is like a lobotomized Leona Lewis tribute act. Oh my god, that's so mean, but it's kind of true. Results show was out of control. Tosser did his toss when they were singing the group number. Lady Gaga performed. She would win Eurovision, wouldn't she? They would love her over there. And you could see her. Oh my god, what are all those accolades about Lady Gaga? She's the most downloaded song in UK history, and she did Bad Romance in a Bathtub. Okay, I'll do it. Ra-ra-a-a-roma, ma-ma-ga-ga, ooh-la-la, want your bad romance. Oh, it's getting so much better. It's like my third time doing it. I'm getting better. Tell me I'm getting better. Don't you dare tell me to stop doing that. I hate when Book sings. And objects in the rearview. Lady Gaga was dressed like Batgirl in the bathtub, and then she took her wings off. I love when she goes like this. It's like the little flower screw in the light bulb, and she twists and shouts. I love when she twists. I think the bathtub was symbolic. Like, you might think I'm dirty, but it's okay, because I'm in a bathtub. $5 says Adam Lambert is going to perform in a shower on The View next week. I'm clean! It was one of the least freaky performances she ever did. She kept yelling, "What's up, X Factor?" Because unlike Bruce Springsteen, she knows where the hell she's performing. What's up, Hulu? Was that Bruce Springsteen who was in the news recently where he said, "What's up, Cleveland?" And he was somewhere else. I'm off topic. Then Gaga started playing the bathtub like it was her piano. Classic. So she wasn't taking a bath. It was her instrument. Rah, rah, nah, nah. Janet Jackson performed too. She didn't sing a single note. She lip sang, "Ah, for you." It's a great song. And she would like yell into the microphone to make you think, "X Factor." But you know, you could have sang a little. All right, I'll do it. All the girls at the party loving that body, shaking that thing like you never did see. Got a nice package, all right. Ollie, 1, 2, 3, 4. How hard was that, Janet Jackson? The whole song is like 2 effing sentences. Then the results. The first act they put through the finals was Ollie. He cried and weeped in Daniel's arms. Then Joe, then Stacy. She looked so sad and serious. Daniel just stood there. They eliminated Daniel. He stood there, took it like a man. He likes to take it like a man, right? Are Lloyd and Daniel doing it? Is that just a rumor? He said he lost to some great people. Simon called him a graceful loser. That was nice. Can't wait for the finals next week. Stop telling me you're not watching X Factor. Watch it. It's so fun. For those of you who don't watch X Factor, let's play Sexiest YouTuber Alive. People Magazine recently released its Sexiest Man Alive issue, and it was Johnny Depp. I kind of agree, but it's like a strange honor. Like, some years it's Matt Damon or Brad Pitt or George Clooney. It kind of depends on who has a movie coming out. Like, if Johnny Depp had a Christmas movie next year, he would have been like, "Ooh, wait, give it to me next year. It'll be more," you know? It's more of a PR thing than a measure of hotness. I always look at the Hot at Any Age page to see if I'm hotter than the person they have listed as my age. A-Rod is my age. Am I hotter than A-Rod? I hope so. Probably not. Everyone in my row looks really old and black. It's like Maxwell, Marlon Wayans, Jay-Z, J-Buck, Buckwow, whatever you call me, Buckwow. It's a great bathroom issue, not for masturbatory purposes. I'm not saying mastery. Number two, to those people's most beautiful, most sexy, best dressed, they're great issues to keep in the bathroom to poop to, not to, but Jill Marini from Dancing with the Stars, there's a 2-page spread. Stop it! People is a family magazine. Poop to it! Who is the sexiest YouTuber alive? Who do you think is most sexy on YouTube? Ian from Smosh, Philly D, The Badonski, Equals3, Cool Jeffrey, Soundly Awake, Keep the Heat, SuperMac18, Shane Dawson, Ryan Higa, Hank from Vlogbrothers, yum. Charlie is so sexy, like, who's the sexiest YouTuber alive? Let me know who you think. Go just pick one of them. Tell me, who's sexy? I'm not counting votes. I'll just take a general eyeball of the balls you pick. Some other quick things. The Sandy Bullock movie, The Blind Side, beat New Moon this week at the box office. It's doing so well. It looks really good. Have you seen it yet? Tell me about it. I haven't seen New Moon yet, only because I was sick for 2 weeks. Forgive me, I will post a review over Christmas. In Oh No News, My Life Would Suck Without You, which has not been on Glee yet, but that's one of my favorite songs on my favorite show, and it sounds terrible. I heard it on YouTube. It was like the worst Glee song ever. It sounded like Kids Bops, and I love Kids Bop, but not when my Glee people sound like it. Finally, did you watch SNL? I tried to sign SNL this weekend. Hottie Blake Lively as the host. I saw some of it. I fell asleep. Keep in mind, I'm old. Same row as Jeter and Jay-Z. There was controversy over the Tiger Woods skit, saying the skit was insensitive because it was about Tiger Woods abusing him with a golf club, and Rihanna was the musical guest, and she'd been abused, so to make fun of domestic violence in the skit wasn't great timing. Thoughts? Am I being lame? What do we all think of abortion? I'm just kidding. Don't tell me what you think of abortion. I've been watching too much Degrassi High. Your baby has fingernails. Fingernails, I tell you. What the Bach? It was going fine until lots of fun videos this week. Stay tuned for stuff on the Jersey Shore, which I referenced. J-Wow. Fred on Hannah Montana and more. Thank you for watching and supporting my videos. Please rate, comment, favorite. Send it to your friends. And I made you a little present for watching the whole thing. Ga ga ra ra, ga ga ra ra. I want your loving and I want your revenge. You and me put on a bad romance. Did you not see it? Did she not look like Batgirl? Did I do this for nothing? She totally looked like Batgirl. Why do you have a Batgirl costume, Buck? Why wouldn't I? Ra ra ga 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 ra ra ba ba da da. Want your bad romance? Ga ga ra ra. Boom, bam, da, na. I want your love and all your love is revenge. You and me put on a bad romance. Whoa, 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 whoa. Caught in a bad romance. Ra, ra, ga, ga. Moo, 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 ma, ma, da, da. Poo, poo, pa. Want your bad romance. I'm gonna get better.